I recently released a video with advanced Tmux features, and man, I think 50% of the comments were a variation of why no Zellij? While I was already dabbling with Zellij, I figured it's time to listen to the audience and press the pedal with getting out of the Tmux comfort zone. After an amazing interview I heard with Aram, the author of Zellij, and the way he views the project, what he has in mind, how he thinks, I decided it's go time. So after a few weeks of usage and having my V60 brew from La Cabra ready, let's go. Zellij is basically a terminal multiplexer, or as Aram, the author, likes to call it, a terminal workspace. The idea he has in mind is something that either offers newcomers to the terminal a nice and convenient system to work with, and for advanced users, some advanced features like we'll see in this video today. You start off by installing with your favorite package manager. Since I'm running on Mac, I'm running brew install Zellij, and that's all it takes. So you start off by typing Zellij as is, and it just throws you into a session, a new session, just like you would in Tmux. Now you immediately notice that you have everything laid out in front of you. Control plus action puts you in a state. That's the first difference, and much more intuitive in my opinion. You're in the mode just like in Vim, where unless instructed otherwise, you can keep going. So if you're in a pain mode, for example, you can just switch between panes. As you go, you can move right, left, up, down using either the arrows or Vim motions. It's coded with color. Orange equals I'm in the mode, and green back to normal. So you can always know what's going on and what state you're in. Before going into the main two killer features, in my opinion, let's quickly go through the other different modes. The first and most important to me are the panes. They are triggered with Control-P, makes sense. One of Zellij's mission statements is to take it and to make it as intuitive and self-explanatory as possible. So you have all the commands laid in front of you, and you don't need to ask questions or query the documentation. No reference is needed whatsoever. The intuitiveness of Zellij is shown everywhere. Take panes resize, for example, where in Tmux you had to resize one axis at a time. This is optional here, but if you just resize a pane, you can see it's growing just like resizing a photo. Super intuitive, it's slick and very thoughtful of the user. When you're in the pane mode, you can use the different shortcuts to do things like rename a buffer or a pane, and enter just takes you back out and approves the operation. As much as I love those Zellij frames, I'd like to set myself in a more Tmux-like environment. So with Z inside the pane mode, I can just remove the frames and get a cleaner look. We'll go back into panes and cover it in depth in a few minutes, but let's start with the other modes. We have lock, which until I hit again, ignores all Zellij commands and any control combinations and locks you into one state. That's again very thoughtful of the user and lets them do stuff if they need to control other options in the keyboard without actually triggering the multiplexer. Then we have the tabs mode that is triggered with Control T. And that can very much be compared to Tmux's windows. Now, you know I love Tmux, but while this is exactly the same feature, the naming and framing and positioning of it on the screen makes it much more intuitive and Vim-like, in my opinion. And while I don't use Vim's tabs, by the way, check out why in this video up here, it feels more natural and more intuitive. There isn't much to explain here, as all the options are laid in front of you. Once you trigger the mode, you can see everything, you can change the focus, create a new one, close, rename, etc. It's all mapped both in your keys and the motions, which is why I love it so much. This is a default mode that comes with Zellij as you install it. One feature that I do want to emphasize is the sync option. This lets your pane run in a sync command. This was very useful to me back in the first days as an ops engineer, where I had to SSH into multiple servers, run the same command on them. While those days are pretty much gone, and with modern architectures like Kubernetes or serverless, this isn't really a thing anymore. It may come in handy every once in a while. And again, in Tmux, that's a hidden key map that I mapped to star. And here, this is a first class citizen. It's part of the tabs feature. So you can run the same commands on the entire set of panes under the same tab. The next mode is the resize mode, which we've covered. So it's just a smooth size change between visual panes. Another thing you can do with it is you can notice you have square brackets and alt to the bottom right of the screen. And this lets you change the layout in which you're seeing different panes, and it changes between stacked, vertical, horizontal. So you can literally change how you view the different panes. If you view them as a stack, by the way, you can see I can scroll up and down, and every time it zooms into one of the open stacked panes, where I can then move to the next one or previous one. And that's a nice way to view things and to use them in different use cases. Session is much like Tmux's session that you can detach and reattach back end to. This is very familiar if you're a Tmux user, where Zellij A will reattach you back into the same session that you started earlier. Now check out what, in my personal opinion, beyond the intuitiveness, the nice looks, the self-explanatory UI, makes a world of difference in Zellij as opposed to Tmux. Let's check my bot logs in production using Fly. Check out the Fly video if you haven't already. So with Fly logs, I can see the logs flowing in from production. And with Control P and F, I can take this pane into full screen if I need to. But check out this gem. Press E to edit. And instead of going into copy mode, if you're a Tmux user, you get a full-fledged session of NeoVim with all the goodies you already have. Now, under the hood, it creates a temp file with the screens dumped inside of it, and that's easier to use. And now it's easier to use Vim to copy my log files or search through them by deleting lines. Let's, for example, delete all the lines that have worn in them to just keep the error lines. Now, tell me this isn't 100 times better than Tmux copy mode. And, you know, I do love Tmux, but it seems like there's a new king in town. Obviously, I can save the file for later reference and then reopen it if I need to in another session, edit it, query it, keep it for debug or whatnot. The other feature, which makes my transitioning into Zellij a no-brainer and can make a world of difference, is the floating windows. Let me show you why it makes so much of a difference to me. In pane mode, use W to query a floating window. Now you can create more floating windows, you can hide them at any time, you can re-embed them in the current session or take them back from an embedded mode. You can, of course, rename them, resize them, whatever you want to do. They're just a normal pane that's floating and can be hidden or unhidden. Let me use Z to find my way into the Fatbot project. And now that I'm in the project, I can open any Go files. Let's open just groups, for example. And let's say I want to run tests. If I would like to run tests now, one option is to just open another pane and run it there. Another option would be to open a command line within Vim and run the tests. And while this is nice, it isn't perfect. I can't go back to it for later reference. It's harder to use. So I can open a floating terminal. And that's a plugin I have within NeoVim. I can list it in the description, but it doesn't have a name and it can only be hidden and rehidden. I can't really control the size or the color or what else. And it lives inside a NeoVim session. Now imagine I can open a floating window and a floating pane within that session lets me run the same tests. I can hide them, I can take them back, I can change the size, I can change the title, I can do basically whatever I want with it. In my eyes, that's crazy different. That's the right place for any floating window to live. That's just the way things should work. Now, if you've noticed, my tests don't really pass, and that's quite annoying to me. So let's quickly go and fix the problem and then rerun them. I'm gonna quickly change the type that's being printed from string to a decimal number. And now when that's ready, I'm gonna stage the hunk with age s. This is, by the way, using Git fugitive. If you wanna check out Git fugitive, check out the video up here where I've covered that. So let's run Go tests again, and voila, my tests are now okay. Everything passes within the floating window. And as mentioned before, with E, I can embed it in the original window. I can use F, which I brain mapped to full screen, but that's basically zoom in and zoom out. I can take it out from an embed mode and re-put it in floating mode. This is absolutely incredible. This is everything I ever wanted in terms of a floating window that's being controlled while I'm using Vim. Now let's use fugitive within noise plugin within NeoVim to commit my changes and push the fix to production. Zellij is built with extensibility in mind. As per the author, I'm going to link to a nice interview that Charm Bracelet had with him. You can add plugins or write your own plugins, which are basically either Rust or other language compiled to WebAssembly. One of these plugins that comes pre-built with Zellij is Strider. Strider is just a layout that you can launch Zellij with. With minus minus layout and Strider, you can open it. And that's what you'd normally call in Vim a nerd tree. And what it really is a clone of Ranger. If you don't know Ranger, that's just a navigation tool within the terminal. And I'm gonna do the same, and I'm gonna run Zellij minus L to open the navigation bar. Now I can go to Strider on the left pane and just start opening different files. They will each open in a new pane of its own. Once I'm done, I can close Strider, I can keep it there. It's very convenient to work with. I can pop any pane out or back into embed mode. I can change the name. I can change the layout of the view. Everything you can do in normal mode. All of these are merely the basics and just a first look and feel of Zellij. I promise a follow-up video with more additional advanced features and plugins, which I'm going to cover here. But as you can probably guess just by the first look, I can highly recommend you give it a go.
Okay, Zellij isn't perfect though, and it misses quite a few things you can get with Tmux. The first of which is really important for me, is Tmux Resurrect. Resurrect is a plugin you can get for Tmux, which basically lets you revive the same session that keeps itself auto-refreshed and auto-saved every couple of seconds. And then if you're in a system failure or restart that you probably experience every now and then, the system can launch back to the exact same session with all the windows and panes and tabs and everything you had beforehand, which is really convenient. My Tmux environment didn't really change much, I think, in the last 6 or 7 months at all because of Resurrect. And that's something you can't have with Zellij. There is an ongoing discussion on GitHub. I'm going to leave a link to that below. It's quite a heated discussion, by the way, for some reason, as things get on the internet. But be sure to monitor it, check it out, and I'm sure that really something that makes sense in the coming future. Another thing, the plugin scene. There isn't really much going on as far as Zellij goes. And yes, they have some default plugins. Yes, they have some community plugins like Pomodoro, some timers. You can actually get the same status bar that Tmux has in the shape of a plugin that you can install, but it doesn't have much of a marketplace or, you know, like a flourishing community that develops plugins, just because it's still a raw project. Lastly, the configuration. While the configuration is awesome, it's modern, it's really nice to use, it gives you a lot of options to play around with your terminal experience. It's not robust as Tmux is. You can make a lot of changes. You can change the prefixes. You can change keys. You can obviously change the way things look and feel, but it's not quite there in my personal opinion. So again, not necessarily a bad thing. And by the way, it does have some cool features that Tmux doesn't have in that area. You can set a JSON with key value strings that are basically translating into environment variables that every new pane will have auto set once it's opened. And that's pretty awesome. You can also configure session mirroring. That's basically it. I'm pretty sure it'll quickly ramp up to the same position Tmux is. And honestly, just Resurrect would be a game changer here and would make the transition so much easier for me, and I'm sure for many other users that you'll see on the discussion I've linked and on other areas. That's it. If you're still unsure, check out the Tmux vid and the other terminal productivity videos. Thank you. See you on the next one.